for one, am grateful, Mrs. Bush, that they are finally bringing civilization to this savage land.
I could not agree with you more, my dear. My daddy settled this land, and I know he'll be looking down on us, pleased at how we helped the natives.
Yes, they've lost their land, but they've gained access to heaven.
But Father, do you mean unless an innocent receives communion, they're destined to go to hell? That hardly seems fair.
What I mean to say, Jenny, is that there is a great deal of difference between an innocent and a savage.
I never thought of it that way.
Yes, they live like animals, but they're happier now.
Not only do people now have motor cars, Father, but I heard that pretty soon we will be able to fly.
No, only angels can fly, Jenny.
No, apparently people can fly. Didn't you hear? Out in Kansas, a man even got a car to fly.
I hardly think so, Jenny.
Apparently, Mr. Johns wants to run for governor, which is why he's so concerned with cleaning up the state.
Nate Johns.
Yes.
His family is nothing but hillbilly trash that came here after the war. I don't want to be judgmental, but this state should not be ruled by such a disgusting family. A family without class.
Apparently. The Johns family have made a lot of money, and he has a lot of friends in politics.
Mrs. Bush, money isn't everything. There are many things that money cannot buy.
It seems that money can buy voters, though.
What you must remember, my dear, is that we have been brought here to spread the word. And the word and civilization, they are the same thing. They are the gifts. It is the opportunity we have, the chance to live among people who are decent and who do not kill each other, and who let you worship in peace.
It's so confusing, Father. Sometimes I find it impossible to make the distinction between a loving act and a hateful one. I mean, they often seem to be the same thing.
Yes, Jenny, it is confusing. But you only have to ask me if you need help.
Indeed.
Well, here we are, Mrs. Bush. Armadillo.
How do you do, sir?
Look what flooded into town!
is still around?
You're drunk.
Walton Crew has been getting rich, gathering twin rocks.
Go down, Bill, anyway.
I don't feel too good.
Good evening to you.
Get your newspaper.
I don't feel too good.
John Marston.
Sometimes.
I'm Jake. Your friends from Blackwater hired me to gag you.
They ain't my friends, but pleased to meet you, Jake.
I got the horses saddled up and ready out front. Mr. Marston, let's get. If you say so.
Here I am.
Take it slow on the way out of town. No need to kick up a lot of dust. Nobody up to the fort in a long time. Giddy up.
Yeah.
Are you planning on spending any time in Armadillo, Mr. Marston?
I doubt it. I ain't planning on staying very long.
Well, if you're fixing for some female company, you can do a lot worse than Armadillo. Fine as cream gravy they are. Not like Steve Brandon. Dang, those girls ain't even fit for a drinking man to hold up with. Yeah! Oh, it was the marshal who hired me. Lee Johnson, do you know him? Talkative, are you?
Nope.
I'm just chewing the dog, mister. That's how I am. I don't mean nothing by it.
Trust me, there's things you're better off not knowing.
Yeah, yeah. You don't look much like no Blackwater fella.
That's because I ain't.
Well, I'm being honest, I don't care much for those highfalutin' big city types. Not much at all.
Blackwater ain't much of a city. More of a town with delusions, but no, me neither. Whoa there.
Giddy up. A fella told me he was out in Blackwater a few months back and stole one of them newfangled carriages without horses.
Is that so?
And you wind him up like a cop. Damnedest thing ye ever saw without the aid of liquor, he told me.
Times are changing fast, that's for sure.
Now who's this friend you're looking for?
Nobody you need to concern yourself with.
Never you mind all my questions, Mr. Marston. I just reckon you might be barking at a knot heading for the fort. You look like a man with a lot on his mind, Mr. Marston, so I won't bother you none with my chatter.
Yeah.
Mr. Marston, the fort's just over this hill.
Listen, mister, this here is what's left of Fort Mercer. Some gang rode in and took the place over.
So I understand.
This is where we part ways, friend. You have yourself a good time.
Come for you! Bill Williamson! Come out here right now!
Go away now, John! Don't make me kill you!
Nobody needs to kill anyone, Bill!
You must think I was born yesterday. You always did think I was an idiot.
That ain't fair, Bill. You were as my brother. I've come to try to save you.
Oh. Do I look like I need saving?
Bill, please. They want to kill us all. I can help you.
Well, you never tried to save me before. You only seemed to save yourself.
Bill. I implore you, think about this.
You implore me? You implore me. You always were one for fancy words. Oh. Well, things are different now, John. Now I'm in charge! No more Dutch! And no more you. Implores. I implores you to go back and tell them to send someone just a little bit more impressive next time.
Well?
Oh. Poor John.
Well, you're alive.
So it would seem.
So, how do you feel?
I don't know the polite word for it.
I do. Stupid is the word we use around here. What were you doing?
I was doing something stupid.
Well, you'll be okay. Once you didn't die, the doctor said you'd be fine. He got the bullets out a couple days ago.
Good.
It cost us $15.
I'm sorry, madam. Should have left me there to die.
Did you want to die? I mean, was that it? Was that why you went straight out to Fort Mercer and picked a fight with the worst bandit in the county? To die,
Mr. Marston. John Marston.
Bonnie McFarlane. Miss Bonnie McFarlane.
Well, you may be right, Miss McFarlane. I don't know.
Huh. So what were you doing?
Trying to give Mr. Williamson a chance, for old time's sake.
You know Bill Williamson?
Knew him, long time ago.
Well, what was he like?
Dumb.
Just like you.
Thank you, miss. Seen my hat?
I have. And, what will you do now?
Now I'm gonna take my time and go after him the less kind way.
Well, that sounds very fun, Mr. Marston. Quite heroic, just like in those penny dreadfuls my brother used to read. Meanwhile, if you'll excuse me, I've got a ranch to run. Of course, if you're feeling better, why not take a ride with me later and help me patrol the perimeter? You can earn back some of that money we wasted on doctor's bills.
Of course. And thank you for saving my life, I mean.
Next time, Mr. Marston, I strongly recommend you don't try to lose it quite so earnestly.
I'll bear that in mind. Howdy. Hello there.
Greetings.
Thank you.
Marston. Back in the land of the living, I see.
Figured it's about time I started paying back that $15.
I sure can use an extra pair of hands around here. Let's see if we can get you back in the saddle. There's the foreman's office. It's also where we lock up good-for-nothing outlaws, such as yourself.
I'm happy enough with my current quarters right now, Miss McFarlane.
I picked out a fine horse for you. Yeah! Come on, then. I'll show you around the property. To your right is the general store. You won't find Parisian high fashion, but it's good for the essentials.
Very convenient. I don't think I've ever seen a ranch with its own store before.
And here's the corral. This one's for the horses. What do you think?
I'm no expert, but it certainly looks like a fine corral.
I suspect you've stolen more horses than you've broken.
Now, where'd you get such an idea?
First impressions are hard to erase. Try to keep up, will you?
Let's go!
That's the train station. Things sure have changed since the line finally got finished.
Go!
Yee-up! That's the barn over there. Paul built it himself when I was just a little girl. Yeah! Come on, Mr. Marston, pick up the pace!
Let's go!
And here we are, back at the house. Let's stop for a while before we head out on patrol.
You'll get no complaints from me, Miss McFarlane.
How about a cold drink, Mr. Marston?
Thank you, ma'am. Getting shot, then riding a horse seems to take it out of you. I could use a rest.
Sure. Come on in. I'll show you the house, and then you can sit for a while.
Thank you.
Mr. Marston.
Miss McFarlane.
Remember me telling you about the trouble we've been having with rustlers and other undesirables?
I do.
Will you help me keep watch on the property line this evening?
Sure.
I want to see just who is trespassing on our land.
This is a fine weapon.
Come, let's head out. The country is really beautiful at around this time. on, then. Let's mount up and take a look around. Let's go. Keep your eyes open, and try not to get yourself shot again.
Let's go!
Thank you, Mr. Marston. I feel a lot happier someone's along with me.
I feel a lot happier now I got a rifle.
Well, with your trigger itch and my feminine intuition, we should make quite a team. Critters. Let's mount up and patrol the rest of the property. We should keep moving. There's still a ways to go.
Come on!
If it's not the rustlers stealing our cattle, it's the rabbits stealing our crops.
It ain't never easy living off the land like this. Maybe you should move to a big city, become a lady of leisure.
Handle a rifle.
It's something I've had a little experience in.
Maybe Bill Williamson did get lucky after all.
Luck didn't really come into it, miss.
You're a useful man to have around the ranch, that's for sure. But don't think I've forgotten what brought you here. We'll do whatever we can to help you.
I sure appreciate that, Miss McFarland.
Mr. Marston. Thank you for your help, Mr. Marston. Makes me kind of happy I saved your life. Get some sleep and I will see you in the morning.
Good night, Miss McFarland.
having a look at me, though. How are you doing?
Those folks in Thieves Landing have been sniffing around here again?
You don't